which can be interpreted in several ways. So where we refer this term management as an activity, or we refer this as a process, and one more thing as a economic resource. So these are the three interpretations which we did in the last session. So in this session, we'll be thinking this, or we'll be interpreting this management as a team. We'll be interpreting this management as a team. So when you're considering this management as a team, so what is that? So you know that as a group of people, management will consist of those who have the responsibility of guiding the efforts of other people or coordinating the efforts of other people. So these people, what they are called? So these people are called as managers. So these managers can be operating at different levels in an organization. They can be in the top level management, they can be in the middle level management, or they can be in the lower level management also. So management, when you're considering this management as a team, so we'll have a group of persons. So it is about managing the group of persons. So management will consist of these people who have the responsibility of guiding and coordinating the efforts of other people. So as a team, so when you talk about an organization, every team will have a set of people who will be guided by the manager or who will be monitored by the manager. So these people, they'll be at the different levels. So some will be operating at the lower level, some will be operating at the middle level, and some will be operating at the top level. So we have middle level management, we have low level management, we have top level management or high level management. So what these managers will do? So these managers will have some kind of ownerships in the organization, and some would have become managers through their experience. So the civil servant, defense personnel, who will manage this public sector undertakings, known as PSUs. So they will also be a part of management team. So these managers have become an elite class in the society who are occupying some positions with an enormous power and prestige. So management as a team. So when you're taking this management as an academic discipline, so we can also consider this management as an academic discipline. So here it will have principles, it will have practices. So when you're taking this management as an academic discipline, so it will have principles, it will have practices which are there for the effective management of organization. So for the effective management of organization, this academic discipline, so this management will have it will consist of certain principles and practices for the effectively managing. So it is a specialized branch of knowledge. So the management has emerged as a specialized branch of knowledge where it is having the principles and practices for the management of organization effectively. So nowadays management has become a very popular field of study. So you can see we have so many institute which is offering the management courses. So there is a heavy demand for the management courses also. And also this courses or career is a very good career. It's a challenging career as well as the rewarding career. And also you can interpret this management as a group. You can interpret this management as a group. So management means the group of persons who are taking or who are handling that, who are occupying the managerial position. So all those individuals will perform the managerial function. So it can be like chief executive, or it can be managing director, it can be the departmental heads, it can be the supervisors, so on. So all this are collectively known as management. So what these people are doing? So they are performing the managerial functions. So it can be, you can take the management of some Tata Industries or some other organization. So here they are managing the company. So the companies can be like, it can be managed. So we can have several kinds of manager, several types of manager which can be like some can be like the family managers, like they become the managers because of being the owners of that company or because of the relatives of the company. It can be like CEOs, so those who have founded the company, so they are the managers, so family managers. So family manager in the sense which they would have become because of their because of being the owners of the company or a very close associate or very close relative for the owner of that company. Or the it can be like professional managers. The professional managers, because of their degree, they would have got this position. And civil servants. Civil servants, you know that they always manage this public sector undertaking. So they have become very powerful and also a respected group in the society. Why? Because the senior managers of the company are the one who are taking the decisions or who are responsible for the decisions which will affect the lives of large number of people. So that is, for example, the Tata Industries, they will decide to expand a production unit. So they decide to expand a particular sector of business. So because of this decision, it will create thousands of jobs for the people. So like indirectly, these managers also help in improving the social life of the public or the economic progress of the country. In addition to this, the senior managers will also have a very high standard of living in the society. So because of which they would have become an allied group. So this is so these are the things which the management is being interpreted. So one is like management as a team, where we have management at the three different levels: high level management, low level management, and the middle level management. So and the second one is management as an academic discipline. So we have subjects, we have branches, or we have management as a specialized branch of knowledge, where it is having some principles, practices. All those things will teach about the effective management of an organization. And one thing is management as a group. So management as a group, in the sense, the group of people who are performing, who are occupying the managerial positions, and they are responsible for performing the managerial functions. So like this. And also we categorize few managers. So some can be like the family managers, because they have founded the company, they would have become the managers, or their close relative or relatives would have found the company, or their relatives being the owners of the company. Or second thing is professional managers. So the professional managers, in a sense, they have got this managerial position because of their degree, because of their knowledge, like that. And the next thing is civil servants, who are responsible for managing, making the decisions, or who are managing the public sector undertakings or PSUs. And also one example which I gave is this Tata Industries. If they decide to expand a production unit in certain locations, so it will indirectly help in the economic progress of the country, and also it will improve the life of the public because it is creating an n number of jobs, somehow 10,000 jobs, 1,000 jobs, like that. So like this. So these are the ways in which the management is being interpreted.